Hello everyone and welcome to phase two of the Outpost Zimonja build. Here is what I've done since last time you saw this. I've attracted some more settlers, I've got some guards, I've got three prisoners in there. They are going to be working on crops because at this point I don't have the expanded settlement mats for their thing. What else has changed is this area right here, the concrete part. I turned this into, oh yeah, I added some turrets. There's my cool looking guard. Yay, UCO, that's a mod. Give him a new skin on the Covenant armor. But yeah, there's the little bunkhouse, and I'm standing on top of the concrete stuff that we did the last time. I changed this all up in here to put the water pumps underneath there and to make this the little workshop area. I don't know if this is going to stay this way, but for now it looks pretty good. And then you look over here. I got, you know, some other crap up there, missile turrets. I dropped down a fusion generator. And today we're going to be building the comms tower. So the comms stuff is out there. I did a little prep work and I put these foundations down here so I would have a good place, so I'd know where the boundaries were. And yeah, there he is with the shotgun. Looking good. He looks really good. And then, of course, I got a cow, which is dead. There was an attack since then. And the super mutants killed it. So let's get started with this bad boy and build a comms tower with the scaffolding base in the corner here. Because this is kind of the highest spot on this side, and I didn't really want to use a radio tower for this. So let's talk about the penal colony aspect of this, that what I referred to last time, and then completely forgot to talk about because I had the attention span, apparently, of a sparrow. So the concept behind this thing is, like, they want to have a place for prisoners, people who have done bad things, wrongdoing, what have you. Okay. The problem with this concept is they already have a penal system in the Commonwealth. They already have a, quote, justice system. And, you know, you got to give them points for efficiency. It's pretty efficient. Anything and everything is punishable by death. Okay, well, that's quick and easy. If you steal from somebody, the entire town will come and kill you. Yeah, dude, sorry, that dented can, that's not yours. You need to put that down. Let's kill you. You can get killed for impersonating someone. You can get killed for your relatives thinking you're a synth. You can get killed for being a synth. You can get killed for, hell, you go to Good Neighbor and the guy tries to shake you down with this cheesy scam. And then Hancock just guts him right there in the street. And everybody's like, you know, just another day in the Commonwealth, I guess. So with that type of, you know, quote, system already in place, it's difficult to say, well, you know, you get caught stealing, I'm going to put you in jail. It's like, well, no, by the time you got around to incarcerating them, they'd already be dead. So there has to be a little bit of flexibility in terms of how are you going to make a non-lethal punishment a thing? How do you even do that? And the only answer I can come up with for that is that as settlements get larger, as they get more, you know, established, and as they're more regular, there's less transients, there's less, you know, influx, outflux, there's less death. You know, it's more of a stable population, like, you know, like, say, Diamond City. So as they get more of a stable population, here I am thrashing with this stupid thing. I'm never going to learn about build order. I always talk about it, and then I forget about it when I'm doing this. It's like, dude, there's nothing for it to snap to. You're not going to get it to snap. You need to have something to snap. I'm like, oh, yeah, I need to snap something. So let me build the central part of this up, and I'll snap it to that, except I can't get it to fit. So then I go, oh, well, I'll just do the side things. Basically, this whole sequence right here is me attempting to get something to snap. So they have to have a stable population. You have to assume a stable population. And so you're like, okay, but that's the thing about a justice system and, you know, incarceration, prisons, punishment, penal system, whatever. That's the end result. That's not the disease. It's a symptom of a justice system. You know, what you need first is you need law and order. You need laws. You need a stable citizenry. You need police. You need people who aren't security guards, because literally there's no cops in the Commonwealth. Diamond City is security. Covenant is security. There's nobody in, well, there's like the what do they call them, a good neighbor, the neighborhood watch, I guess, but there's no cops anywhere because there's no law. I mean, even Diamond City, what's his name, the guy that helps you out with Bobby, the dude with the bot, I forget his name, but even Mel. But even he's only in lockup for like a day, you know? It's like they just put him in there to cool off. It's like a drunk tank. It's not even like a real penalty thing, and really, you can walk in and pick the lock and walk out, and the car's just like, yeah, whatever, it's fine. We're going to let them out tomorrow anyway. So how do you establish a penal system? So we're just going to have to do a lot of fudging here. So what's going to happen is, since Randall here is ex-military, he's just the male sole survivor, is military, I'm going to assume he's going to establish a military justice system of sorts, based on what he remembers, because he wasn't an MP, he doesn't know. So he'll probably set up like a tribunal. There'll be like three people, you know, like a guard, a witness, and him to pass sentence on people. So at some point I'm going to build a little room in here with a desk and a dais and, you know, three chairs and an elevated thing, like a judge thing. We'll see what we can do with mods. And then of course I need a power station, need somewhere to put the power. But the good thing is I got the whole arc back there where you can see where the cow is and the guard stations. So I'm basically just going to arc this thing around the top of the bank, I think. And we're going to be using mods here. In this one, I do use a chair from a mod. I have since deleted the mod I used here because I found that Andrew CX put out Unlock Settlement Objects for Xbox, and it is functionally identical to the PlayStation version. This makes me very, very happy. So now I can use the same, quote, the same mods that everybody has access to. I mean, yeah, some people have better mods. You know, they have more snap points and whatever. But, you know, I played around with it. And oh my God, it has so much stuff in the wood section. I'm gonna faint. It's so awesome. So yeah, expect to see more wood buildings coming up pretty soon, because the half height pieces are in there, the half width pieces are in there, that little angled corner piece with the chain link fence, and it has chain link fences. Ah, chain link fences. I've been waiting for. Yeah, that ain't gonna fit. So the power station is gonna go up later. So yeah, mods I'll be using are for the PS4 people. You have that one called Scrap Skeletons and Leaves. I'll be using Scrap Fallout, same thing pretty much. We're both going to be using Unlock Settlement Objects. We're both going to be using, what's the other one? What's the other one? I can't remember. But I'm not going to be using any mechanics ones. I'm not going to be using any greenery ones. It just looks weird to be having green. I'll probably use the plants one, you know, the one where you can grow thistle or whatever for food. Oh, the settlers. There's one where you can get rugs for settlers. I'm going to be using that one. Where they, you know, they're like, they can do animations and stuff. You can assign them or they'll just, you know, wander into it. It's called Busy Settlers, I think. And then I have another one. It's a scavenging mod. I don't know if PS4 users get this. I hope you do, because I'm going to be using the hell out of it, because it's cool as hell. Basically, it makes scavenging stations out of anything. Consoles, Tinker Tom's desk, you know, filing cabinets, shelves full of stuff. It's really cool, and I like it. I mean, I don't really use scavenging stations because... why? I've got so much crap, I don't need to scavenge anymore. So this is a neat thing I'm going to be using a little bit more as well, especially when you consider that the wood will snap to the scaffolding. Then you take the scaffolding out and then you snap it up or whatever. So what you can do is, if you use the scaffolding as a snap guide, you can make, you know, those shanty towns, the elevated multi-level shanty towns, really, really easy. Because the scaffolding is, you know, it's barn height, it's not wood wall height. So you can set up the wood base, like that little window there, build your building, take the scaffolding out, put, you know, a shack foundation underneath it, and then build another one, like right above it. It's like, see how it's just barely above it? So you can actually stack these things, and if you use the 1x2 pieces instead of the 2x2s, you can snap them to those frames, right? So you can have them at half heights and you can have them at half width, and then you can just snap your floors to them and have this like conglomeration of buildings. Yes, these won't snap to those with the scaffolding in place. Those walls won't snap. So here, necessity, mother of invention. Okay, can't snap them? Good. We're just going to make little balconies. Hell with it. Fine, whatever. So that's what's going on with the penal colony. That's what's going on with the mod situation. I will say this too, if you do have the little scrap mod thing, one weird thing I found out about is when you're running that scrap mod and you play in the game, it does really weird things to the physics of the entire game, okay? Like in survival, right? I use vertebrates a lot, okay? Sure, I fly all over the place. What I found is when I have the scrap Fallout mod disabled, the vertebrates will climb, right? They'll change elevation. They'll go over buildings. They'll go over overpasses. You know, they'll see it as a collision object and they'll maneuver around it or over it or whatever. But when the scrap Fallout mod's running, they literally never change height. I fly through buildings. I fly through mountains because it doesn't see it doesn't see the architecture, the landscape, as a solid object anymore because the scrap fallout thing is running. So if you see weird things like that happening, it's probably because you have the scrap, that scrap thing, because it changes the physics of most of the game world, which is strange to think about. Okay, here I am checking. Yep, okay, I've got the pip for starlight. So I'm gonna make sure this thing's aligned. So we're gonna stick it up at the top. And this is what I do a lot too, is I put things together like this, and then once I have powered objects, I immediately stop whatever I'm doing, hook them up, make sure they've got power. I don't know why I do this. It doesn't matter that they have power or not. They're there for now. But I'm pretty proud of this. I remembered where it was, and look at that. Lined it up on the first try. Booyah. So, yeah. But yeah, my poor cow. My cow died. The super mutants came over that back hill. I got to do something about that back hill. I got to put some defenses up over there, because I forgot there's a spawn point back there. And so, yeah, my cow died. My modules, disable scrap fallout, penal colony. I'm actually starting to write notes on the whiteboard so I can sort of pay attention to what the hell it is I'm doing. And here we go with the snap thing again, trying to get that thing to snap. I'm getting better at scaffolding. I mean, I'm not terrible anymore. Yeah, so one thing that's really strange about playing this guy, this character here is the one I played the longest by a considerable margin. And I mean, geez, I haven't gone to the Institute yet. I mean, really? I gotta go to the Institute, man, because I can't get Dance as a companion until I go. And I really want his perk. Because of course I got a mod that whenever you do something with your companions, it maxes their affinity immediately. So I can get their perks, and then I can stick them in Covenant and just call it a day. Because, man, I hate companions in this game. I hate having somebody with me because the AI is so terrible. You know, I'm a stealth build. I'm trying to sneak around, trying to do stuff. Like Dogmeat, he's the worst. He just charges all over the place. You know, points for enthusiasm, dog, I get you. But dude, if I'm sneaking, could you just not run through the laser wires? Could you not run over the mines? Could you just not do that, please? Could you just heal? Can I teach dog meat to heal? That'd be fantastic. So yeah, I don't like the companions, but I like their perks, so I wanted to max their affinity. Plus, I like doing their quests, you know? I mean, this is the first time I've ever done MacReady's quest. I've never actually done I've never been inside the back of, what is it, MedTech? Yeah, MedTech. With or without a hyphen, depends on where you look. If you look at the screen, if you look at the label, it's with a hyphen. But if you look at the sign, it doesn't have a hyphen. And yeah, I noticed things like this. Yeah, that's great. Yeah, one of these is I'm gonna give you guys a video on how did that get in there? That's one of my big things. That and just the weird things like the roundabout. You know, there's that one roundabout where there's that guy, that raider with his dogs in the bus. The next time you're over in that section, take a look at that roundabout and ask yourself, what's that inside lane for? Where are they going? No. Clearly the developers have never been in an actual roundabout, or whoever designed that has never actually driven in one, because that's an infinite inside lane. I don't know what they're doing with that. But anyway, we're getting close to getting done here. The lights are on. It's getting dark. I'm going to put the chair down. See, this is the mod I was using, DFVP. Decorative something. It means it's an acronym. And that's the chair I like, that little black chair, because you don't get that everywhere. But I found that it's in Unlock Settlement Objects. And I got to say, props to Andrew CX for putting the stuff in the menus where it makes sense. Like, I went through it last night, spent about, God, it must have been 45 minutes just going through stuff. And, man, everything's where it should be. I'll remember where the stuff is. So we're slowing down now. We're almost done here. This looks a little bit different. I made some changes to it, but for the now, this will be fine. So I want to again say thank you to all my current subscribers and welcome to my new subscribers. I hope you're liking what you're seeing. And on our next episode, we will be building a powerhouse, a power building, or a tribunal building. I want to thank you all very, very much for watching. I am hoping you're having an excellent holidays, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.